Hello students, welcome back to this session on electromagnetics and EMFT. And today in this session we are going to talk about the differential elements. Okay, so we'll be talking about the differential elements in the case of Cartesian coordinate system, cylindrical coordinate system and the spherical coordinate system. What are differential elements? Differential elements are the three elements: differential displacement, differential surface area and differential volume. So differential displacement and differential surface area are both vector quantities, whereas differential volume is a scalar quantity. So now with the help of these three diagrams, we'll be seeing what is differential displacement, what is differential surface area and what is differential volume in the case of these three type of coordinate system. Okay, so now we are beginning our discussion with the Cartesian coordinate system. So here we have x, y and z axis. So along x axis we have ax unit vector, along y axis we have ay unit vector and along z axis we have az unit vector. Okay, so this thing should be clear. Now we have a small volume. This volume is very small. So now we have this small volume and here the D point is x, y, z coordinate. Okay, so the coordinates of D point is x, y, z. Now suppose I have to move from D to point R. So what I can do, I can follow this path. I can move from D to C first, then C to Q, and from Q to I can move to R. So if I have D to C, this is representing some change, some small change in the y axis. So here we had y axis, some small element of y direction is represented as dy. Here it is the small element of x direction, it is represented as dx. And this is the small element of the z direction and it is represented as dz. Okay, so now here if I have to move from here to here, so what I'll be doing, I will be adding dy along ay, dx along ax and dz along az. So what is my differential displacement? So I represent it with dl. So differential displacement is given as, so again, dy ay plus dx ax plus dz az, or I can rearrange it and I can write it down like okay, so this is my differential displacement. You can see I have unit vectors along dl. So dl is represented by a vector and dl itself is a vector quantity. So this is how I represent dl. It's the small element, dl is the small displacement in this volume. Okay, so now we'll be talking about the differential surface. So I will be telling you what is the formula of differential surface. Differential surface can be represented as ds n cap. So this is the representation of ds n cap, where n cap is a unit vector normal to the surface. Okay, so whenever we have the surface, we'll be taking the normal direction to the surface and this normal should be away from the volume. So here we can have various surfaces in this diagram. So if this is my box, in the box I can have, so this is a DCB surface, or I can have PQRS surface, okay, or I can have CQBR surface. Like this I have six surfaces. But like if I am talking about this surface normal direction will be always away from the volume. So volume is inside it, so its n cap will be outward direction. Okay, so here in this case also, this is the BRCQ. So BRCQ is this, inside it we have the volume, so will be taking N cap to be in outward direction. So I hope there is no confusion about N cap. So now if I have to represent the area of this diagram, so now here we have dy and dz. So now so for this ds we'll be having surface area dy into dz, and what is the normal to it? So y and z are the direction, so the normal to it will be x, so we'll be having ax cap. Similarly, we have ds is equal to dx into dy az cap, and ds is equal to dx into dz ay cap, and for different surfaces we have different normal. Okay, so whatever normal we are taking it to be normal to the surface, and it should be away from the volume. Okay, so it's in the away direction from the volume. Now what about dv? dv will be equal to simply multiplication of dx, dy and dz. So because it is a scalar quantity, we don't have any direction to it. So now I hope these things are clear. Special focus must be given to the differential surface area. So in differential surface area, we have n cap, which is the normal, which is normal to the surface of the consideration. So here if I have dy dz surface, the normal will be outward direction x. So here we have ax cap to be the direction. So now I hope this thing is clear. Now we'll be moving toward the cylindrical coordinate system. Here you can see this is my cylindrical coordinate system. In this cylindrical coordinate system, we have rho, phi and z direction. You know now what is rho, phi and z. If you have still not watched my previous video on these three coordinate system, I recommend you strongly to watch the video first, because I am using those things here in this video. So now here we have what is phi, azimuthal angle, rho, the radius here, and what is z? Z is the height. So now we'll be having the cylindrical surface, and here we have a very small differential cylindrical surface. Now here we'll be seeing what is the differential displacement, differential surface area and differential volume in this case. So now here you can see if I have any point r and the coordinate of r is rho, phi and z, now I have to move to the point A. Okay, so what all coordinates I require? I require RQ. What is RQ? RQ will be equal to this element AD. So RQ is d rho, which means differential radius. Okay, so RQ is d rho. Now where I'll be moving? From Q to B. So what is QB? QB is rho d theta, and how I calculated it? Okay, so here we have a small volume, and for this I have small angle d phi, and for this small angle d phi I have radius here rho. I know this is the arc of this circle. The arc of this circle is given by radius into angle, so this arc will be given as rho into d phi. Okay, I hope there must not be any confusion about this arc. Arc is given as radius into angle. So radius is rho, angle is d phi. So arc is rho d phi here. So this QB will be rho d phi. Okay, now I'll be moving from B to A. What is B to A? B to A is differential element dz. Okay, now if I have to denote what is the differential displacement, so differential displacement in this case will be referred as okay, so d rho in the direction of a rho, rho d phi in the direction of a phi and dz in the direction of az. So if I add all of these three, I will be getting differential length. Now what about differential surface area? So here also we'll be using this formula. The surface area will be having a normal, which is giving me the direction of the surface area. So it is also a vector quantity, and ds will be also a vector quantity. So it is also given as ds n cap, where n cap is the direction of the surface area. Okay, so now okay, so the differential surface area will be equal to d rho into rho d phi. What I have done, I have seen that we have three directions. Okay, in the three direction, I have these to be the coordinates. So the length, I will multiply and I will get the surface area. So if I multiply the length of two coordinates, I will get the surface area. And what would be the direction? The direction will be given by the third coordinate. So if I multiply d rho with rho d phi, what will be the direction? Direction will be az. So d rho into rho d phi will be giving me direction az. Now if I am taking rho d phi and dz, so rho d phi when multiplied with dz, so direction will be a rho. Now dz multiplied with d rho, what will be the direction? Direction will be a phi. So this is how I can find out the direction of the differential surface area. Now we'll be moving to the differential volume. So in the differential volume, I will just multiply the coefficients of each of the length. So here I have the coefficient d rho, here rho d phi, here dz. So I'll be multiplying all of them and I will be getting differential volume and no direction, because it is a scalar quantity. Okay, so I hope these two things are clear. The differential elements in the case of Cartesian coordinate and cylindrical coordinate are clear. Now, you are imagining the differential elements in the case of spherical coordinate system. Yes, it is the same process which we'll follow in the spherical coordinate system as well. So here we have this differential volume. In this differential volume, I need to find out differential length. So here, in this volume, if I am moving from this point to this point, what I'll require? I require this distance. So what is this distance? This distance is given by this rho d phi. So this distance and this distance is equal, and it is given by rho d phi. What is rho? Rho is here the radius here at the base, and here we have the differential angle d phi. So this arc will be rho d phi, and this arc will be equal to this arc. Okay, so now here this will be rho d phi. Similarly, here this arc will be equal to r d theta, because here we have differential angle d theta and the radius here is r. Okay, so this arc will be r d theta. So now here we'll be moving from here to here, so we'll be having this coordinate and this coordinate. So one coordinate is dr, then we have rho d phi, and then we have r d theta. So now dl, obviously it will be the addition of all of these three. So now dr in the direction of ar plus in the direction of phi, we have rho d phi, and what was rho? I know rho is equal to r sine theta. Okay, so I know what is the relationship of rho and r. I have proved this relation in the previous video where I discussed about the spherical coordinate system. Okay, so now here I'll be putting the value of rho. So rho is r sine theta d phi, and direction is a phi, plus now here we have r d theta, and the direction is d theta. So direction is a theta. Okay, so now DL must be clear now. So now we'll be moving toward the differential surface. Again, we'll be using the same trick. If I am using this and this length, then it will be normal to this direction. Okay, so now here you can see that if I need to find out DS, so if I am taking this length and this length, what is this length? DR. What is this length? R sine theta d phi. Okay, so what is the normal? Normal should be now a theta. Okay, so this thing should be clear now. Now we'll be talking about next ds. So here if I'm taking this distance and this distance, so here I'll be having r square sine theta d phi d theta. Now direction would be ar. Okay, so I hope this thing is now clear. Now we'll be talking about third ds. So the third ds I am taking, I have taken these two. Now I'll be taking these two. So here I'll be having r dr d theta. Now direction will be a phi. Okay, so now I hope these things are clear. Now if I have to find out the differential volume, it will be simply multiplication of all the three lengths. So here I'll be having dr d phi d theta, it is multiplied with r square sine theta. So this is my differential volume. So I hope you got each one of the differential element in all of the three coordinate system. So here if you have still any confusion, you can put the doubt in the comment and I will try to resolve it as soon as possible. I hope you like this video. If you like it, share it with your friends, subscribe the channel and do push the like button. Thank you so much.